Friends, welcome back to my channel Hari Wonder. In this video, I am going to explain you about abbreviation, attribute, abstract noun, and much more. Before going into video, please subscribe my channel and click on bell icon. So let's get started our video. So first, I am going to explain you what is abbreviation. Abbreviation, a way of shortening a word by removing its ending. Abbreviation means a way of shortening. That means a way to shorten a word. That means there is a word we are going to shorten that by removing its ending. For example, society. In society, there are 7 letters. What are they? S-O-C-I-E-T-Y. So in that, we are removing its ending. That means I-E-T-Y is removing. Then S-O-C is abbreviation and the full form of S-O-C is society. So after that, I am going to tell you that abbreviations finish with a full stop. Abbreviations finish with a full stop. For example, SOC, after we have to keep full stop, then it is an abbreviation, which means the word society. After that, the term abbreviation is sometimes used to refer to acronym. Contraction and initialism. So about acronyms, contractions and initialisms, I will tell later in another video. So the term abbreviation is sometimes used to refer those acronyms, contractions, initialisms are explained here. After that, absolute. I am going to explain about absolute. So absolute means what? Absolute means adjectives. Like adjectives. There are many forms of adjectives. In those, 3 forms are there. Adjective forms. Absolute is a form of adjective. So, adjectives have 3 forms. Adjectives have 3 forms. They are absolute form, second one is comparative form, and third one is superlative form. In absolute form, for example, we take big. Big is a absolute form. Absolute form. That big, when goes into comparative, it becomes bigger. When it goes to superlative form, it becomes biggest. So, another example, let's say, certain is an absolute form. Then it will get more certain in comparative form and more certain in superlative form. After that, we use the comparative when 2 items are being compared. We use comparative form when there are 2 items and we are going to compare them. That means we are going to differentiate between them. For example, the rabbit was bigger than the cat. So here there are 2 items. That means a rabbit and a cat. Rabbit is differentiating cat. That means the size of rabbit is bigger than cat. Like this, we can use the comparative degree. Comparative degree or comparative adjective. After that, we use comparative when 2 items, we know that. After that, superlative. Let's discuss. The superlative is used when there are more than 2. More than 2 means the Mandela theater is the biggest of the 3. That means there are 3 theaters. For example, there are 3 theaters and in those 3, Mandela theater is very big. That means very large. Then the Mandela theater is comparing with another 2. That means there are 3. More than 2 means superlative degree will be used. So we use the biggest. The Mandela theater is biggest than other 3. So the the absolute form is used when a plain statement is being made without any kind of comparison. Absolute means there will be no comparison between any 2 or anything. Comparison will be prohibited where absolute adjective is used. After that, for example of absolute, example of absolute is Brown is big, strong and gifted athletically. Brown means a person. Brown is big. That means he is big in size and strong. Strong in strength and gifted athletically. That means he can participate and he can participate in athletics. After that, I am going to discuss and explain about abstract noun. Now, the abstract noun means nouns can be divided into two groups. I have explained in last video, so I will give that video's description in its video link in the description. Go to that video and try to watch it. And now I am going to explain abstract noun. Noun can be divided into two groups: concrete and abstract. Concrete and extract. Abstract. Concrete nouns refer to people, places, and things that can be experienced using your five senses. Abstract nouns refer to thoughts, ideas, and imagining we cannot. For example, in concrete noun, man is used. For example, man is in concrete noun. Then the abstract noun for man is manliness. Manliness is abstract noun and man is concrete noun. And second example is table is a concrete noun and tabulation is abstract noun. After that, other is a concrete noun and abstract is a othership. So other is a concrete noun and othership is a noun. So too many acute abstractions can make a piece of writing difficult to read. For example, the sentence in bold type in the following extract. Such people may be keen to work but unable to find jobs because none are available in their occupation or in their geographical area, so that the retraining or rehousing would be necessary to increase the chances of employment. Now I am explaining that will be in bold. It should also be that there is a general deficiency. So these are abstract nouns. So after that, a general deficiency. Now I am explaining main concept. A general deficiency of demand for labor throughout the economy is just a pompous and long-winded way of saying that there are not enough jobs to go around. This is not an abstract noun. After that, abstract nouns means, now I am explaining about abstract nouns. So this is today's video. In next video, I will meet you with acronym. So thanks for watching my video. Please like this video. Bye bye.